Alright! Hello there, I am King Trip Day from Team Dawn. I am part of the sister teams with Team Biscuiteers Dusk, which is on the purple team. On the blue team, we have... Fuck, that music is so loud! Oh god, how do I lower my music? No! Fuck your music! Frustrating. Anyway, let's try something serious. For some odd reason, I can't see their bands. Oh, maybe I can. OP4 bands? Alright. So, bands are for Blitzcrank, Jarvan, Amumu, Kale. Some typical strong bands. Jarvan, obviously, with his great initiating. Damn, your music be so loud. Ah, oh, that's so much better for my ears. Okay, so, Jarvan, good band. He's probably one of those counters to Olaf. Olaf has been picked pretty much popular lately. Oh, the Katarina. Please don't tell me that I was meant to target ban me, but I'm not playing, guys! I'm not playing! Ban! Alright, so I think that's a bug. We can go safely and say that is a bug. I can only see 5, not 6, so... It's probably the Blitzcrank, Jarvan, Amumu ban, Kale, and Katarina. And I'm guessing Malphite would have been a 6, because he's a typical ban. If he's not picked up, he's probably banned. Jarvan, Amumu, Malphite, strong initiators. What can you say about that? The two team AoE, freaking lock, just lock, control one whole team. It's ridiculous. Unfortunately, I did let Shen out. Shen is Portable Decoy's go-to jungler. Don't underestimate the power of Shen. He has almost every skin. Actually, he does have every skin. He has every skin. This guy has no life whatsoever. Anyway, let's hope he's not playing drunk today. So, on Portable Decoy, he is the jungler. He'll be running Shen. I believe Caveman will be mid lane. Clefticles is a support. And Dotkins, the girl who doesn't speak. Yeah, she does not speak at all. She will be running top lane. On the right side, you have Wing Zero, who is a support. Symphonica, the mid laner. ZR Pog's jungle. And he's definitely jungling Udyr. So Udyr and Kali, not too bad. I guess we can run is, like, Udyr will be the frontliner, so in case Shen or something tries to jump onto, you know, the ADC, then he'll be like the whole beefcake frontline, like, no bitch, you're not stunning, you're not touching my guy. And then you got Akali, who'll be the dive-in, the whole jump in, try to get the enemy's ADC, because you still need that sort of assassin thing. Which is pretty weird, like, in a way, they're not knowing Akali. Symphonica is known for Akali, it's her go-to champ. So, both sides, I think, playing their go-to champions, like Shen in the jungle, and then you got Akali and Udyr for Team Dusk. Picking up Lulu and Ezreal, not bad. Obviously, Shen initiating with his taunt into a knock-up from Lulu, that's pretty good AoE disturbing CC. The polymorph will be good against Akali, so if Akali does jump onto the ADC, she'll be polymorphed instantly, and then they can probably like do that sort of counter-initiating. So Akali jumps in, and then instant stun onto Akali, you'll be snare polymorph into a taunt from Shen, and then they can instantly kill Akali, and then there's nothing stopping to Rabid Gaming from pretty much losing their ADC, because at the moment, as looking at Team Dusk, they have no other sort of getting to the back line of Dusk. The Draven and Janna pick, that's pretty nice. You've got the disengage from Janna, because at the moment there is no engagement coming from Team Dusk, except you got all the engagement rocking from Rabid. This shotgun's gonna take forever. Wow! Alright, so you have the disengagement, you also have those good in the learning phase. So Draven is one of the strongest early level 1 ADCs, I think. Yeah, so his Q does a lot of damage. Don't underestimate the power of his Q. It's sort of like critting, in a way. And then mixed with Janna's E, which gives you added AD, it's... Oh, there we go. Sorry, mic cut off again. Anyway, so added with the Janna's E into Draven's Q, I'd expect, like, say, two Qs coming off Draven, two auto attacks, or half health. Ezreal, don't forget, Ezreal is the squishiest ADC in the lineup at the moment. The Anivia and Xin Zhao pick. Okay, again, nice way. Udyr has no real initiating. He's dependent on his movement speed. So what you can rock with is a wall from Anivia would delay Udyr, Janna, Draven from coming. Oh, the Jax. Okay, so back still doesn't change much. The wall will block off three of the team, but only Karl and Jax can get over it. Now, if it's a well-played initiating, what you can do is you'll have Nivea wall, and they can sort of kill off Akali and kill off the Jax. It'll be 2v5 then, because the other team has to sort of go around the wall, otherwise they have to burn flash. That's the downside to Udyr. That is why Udyr is not really that pick, because unfortunately it is a league of blinks. So you can blink over things. Can't really blink without burning his flash. But I'm more inclined, I like the sort of the initiating coming from Team Dusk. You've got Shen, who pretty much just ulties anyone, but what can be well played here is Xin Zhao can jump onto Draven, right? You then get a Shen ultimate onto Xin Zhao. So at first it seems, alright, you've got the two people on the sides, and then all of a sudden you have a Xin Zhao right in the middle of you, and then a Shen right there in a matter of seconds. And this commenting, streaming this? Nah. Recording it though. On. Don't blame me if I fail as a shoutcaster. Alright, so yeah, don't forget, this is my first game of shoutcasting, so wishing me all the luck. But ideally, by looks of this, Team Dusk doesn't really have a sort of good initiating team. They have a good counter initiating. Because you can't really initiate much with Jax. Like, Jax could start to initiate, for instance. He can get his stun up. He can leap onto Ezreal. He can leap onto the back line of Rabid Gaming. Or he can just jump in the middle of them. But the thing is, as soon as he jumps into the middle of them, you can then get the Nivea wall to separate the rest of his team. And it's literally a 5v1. And the only one who can actually get away around the Nivea wall or through the Nivea wall is Akali. So, okay, yeah, she can come in, she can assist him. It'll be 2v5 then. It's still a 2v5. Most times than not, it's not really a good thing. But also the peeling of Rabid Gaming is also good as well. So you've got Jax jumping in. Granted, he stunned everyone. Maybe this stun could last just long enough for Janna's Q to come up, to knock him up, to again chain the CC, and then with the Draven E, like, just chaining CC, just constant disruption, just chaining CC till Udyr gets in the middle, till Akali gets in the middle, till, like, even if Anivia walls, she probably would wall off only Draven, which in retrospect is really strong, unless, like, but then again, that's if all the CC changed successfully for Team Dusk, but in normal... So in retrospect, in reality, him will jump, say gets a stun, but misses Anivia. Again, Mike's stuffing up. Fuck you, Mike. Why do you do this to me? So you got Anivia wall. She cuts off anything. It's 2v5. So now let's look in the fight. You've got them jumping on probably Ezreal. You got Lulu to ulti Ezreal, knocking them up. That's already 1 CC. Knock up. Polymorph the other. So in this time, one is polymorphed, the other one's still knocked up. You then can get a double taunt. So that's another chain CC there. You then got Anivia stun herself. Xin Zhao's knock back slash knock up. So in a way, if anyone tries to jump onto Ezreal, all Ezreal has to do is blink out, or you don't even have to blink out. Chain the CC here, chain the peeling. That eventually, by taunting at least either Akali or Jax, and if Ezreal and Anivia, and if they stay in Anivia's ultimate, they can do enough damage to kill Akali. And then all that's left is literally sit back, kill off Jax and kill off Akali. They've got no one else to jump onto the back line, and then all you need is, like, all you would have is Shen and what's the other guys in Zhao? Just be the frontliner guys, and there's nothing you can do to get back onto them. So we're going into game. I know there's a 3-minute delay because I am spectating the game. So I'm already such a boring shoutcaster. Like, I'm just giving as much facts as I could possibly can. Oh, running all the skins. Alright, so it's Team 4 Silver versus Team 4 Silver. Okay. And it's Team 5 skin v Team 3 skin. Oh, skins win, man. You know that. It's a given fact. Skins always win. It's just proven. Alright, so like that. Now this is going all on the negative side on Team Dusk. But what do they have that works against with them? Well, they've got the instant, like, the jump and instant, like, burst. So if Jux does land a good stun, like, say for instance he does stun Shen, Xin Zhao, Lulu, right, in this whole time there is no one, like, to peel for Ezreal. And then, and I know for a fact, Wing Zero and Baker have a good sort of synergy in chaining their CC. So that's what's running with them as well. This team also has good synergy. They've been communicating well, they, even though Baker is a sub, so, like, in these two teams, both are running two subs. Rabid's running Caveman and Dotkins as subs, and Team Dusk are running Baker as a sub. So we're into the game now. I'm just going to refix all this. Make it look nice and sexy. Ooh, what the hell? Whee! This is funny. Okay, I want the top lane top. So Xin Zhao and Jax. So back to the thing. So they can chain CC. They should be able to chain CC pretty effectively. And then, with the chain CC, Akali here. So we've got a running Akali. She's running pretty much... Ooh, early... Is that scaling? I guess that's scaling AP. That's probably scaling AP. She can probably insta-kill Ezreal. Like, don't forget, Ezreal is considered the squishiest ADC at the moment. And Akali has really ridiculous high burst. Ooh, we might see a level 1 invade here. Oh, here we go. It's coming with an invade. Xin Zhao, no, don't walk! Oh, there's the invade! He comes out and has to burn flash. Then team. Okay, again. So you might hear a lot of background noise. I do have a huge family. Again, I'm Lebanese. I got cousins, mothers, aunties, uncles. Okay, so it could work for them. Chain to CC, instant kill Ezreal. Then their main damage dealer is Anivia, who again is very squishy. Like, I play AP mid, I know Anivia, how she works. You gotta egg her, but even if you do egg her, she's a very squishy champion. So that's the difference. They got good peelers, but their main damage dealers, who are Ezreal and Anivia, are quite squishy. And they can be instantly blown up. Whereas with Team Dust, that's what they're running for. Like, they have people that can jump onto these squishy people and instantly blow them up. So that's a good thing running for them. Again, it comes down to how well teams coordinate. Like, for instance, the Rabid Game have got good peelers. They've got good synergy with their champions. They're the initiators, whereas Team Dusk are the counter-initiating. But they have the people to instantly jump onto whoever they please. They've got two people that can jump, Jax and Akali, and instantly blow anyone up. So we'll see how the game goes. Early on, Akali should be beating Anivia. No surprise there, but level 6 onwards, Anivia does overcome Akali, just because Akali has to try and get onto Anivia, but she can just instantly stun and slow. So we got back in top lane, Xin Zhao has burnt flash. See how Jax goes dealing with some like little hits in there. I reckon it'll be a farm fest at first, probably not till level 3, we might not see something. I'm more inclined for bot lane though, because that harassment starts at level 1, there you go. That's one axe, and that's already like a bar and a bit coming off Lulu. That bar and health. That's literally a quarter of her health. Give me a sec. Okay, so I was getting Maccas. Now, top lane, a little trade here and there. It's going to be farm fest. It's more bot. Oh, what did I miss out? Oh, I missed out something. I know I missed out something. Screw you, Mum. I don't want Maccas. Anyway, so both lanes sort of have a poke, a little great poke. A lot of harass. You expect harass is going down a half health a lot. I would like to see the whole Janna sync with Draven E to Q attacks. Like, you would see Ezreal's health melt pretty quickly. Into mid lane, we've got Akali, 7-7, equal farm. So, not much is happening. Team Rabid are pushing extremely hard, but they have a ward here. So they spotted Udyr. They would react fast enough. Does she have Polymorph? No, she doesn't, but she's got Glitter Lance. Here comes the gank. He comes in. Oh, that Q. He's going down. He's... Oh, the shield turtle. That was close, but he did burn his flash. Did they burn any summoner spells? No, they didn't. Well communicated there. Didn't he burn summoner spells? Then either knew he was going to get the kill or not. Didn't have to burn a summoner spell. So coming in the next gank, Udi can't really gank because he's got no blinks. So if he's coming in a gank next time, it'll be a Glitter Lance from Lulu. And then she can exhaust because she still has it up there. Oh, they burnt the ignite. Okay, so the killing potential is lowered. Oh, here comes someone invading. Akali walks into a Shen. Just a little trade here and there. Oh, the stun! Can she get away? Here comes Udyr. Udyr with a... Oh, burning flash of thing. Burning flash for both Anivia and Shen. So, in a way, that came with a good trade. It cost them, pretty much. Akali her ignite, so kill potential is lowered. But they burnt the escape from Anivia and Shen. Back in the bot lane, some little trading. Very aggression play from Rabid Gaming Killer. Going in. Oh, misses a Q. What a shit cunt. It's a pretty typical bot lane, you know. I did expect some pressure, some aggression coming from Rabid Gaming. So Cleft with the good wards. Ooh. Must be a Q landing onto Draven. So again, the ward onto... In front of Dragon, this is a really good ward actually. It shows jungle entrance, so by the time Udyr is here, so you have vision right here for Udyr, they can react instantly. So by the time Udyr gets here, they would probably be here, roughly. So he'll be wasting time running that way. Ah, Cody with his epic ward. That's a skill he's trying to teach me to do. It's a ward where you can ward through here over to there. He has like a 99% accuracy there, hasn't missed one yet. So, that's good ward. Vision, probably not as well, but the thing is, now, Cleftickle doesn't know there's a ward here. They didn't even see him, because normally you'd expect him to probably walk around and ward, but he warded over the wall. So, they don't know about the vision thing, which is pretty good. But that doesn't really stop them, like that, again, so they can play as aggressive as they want. All the aggression can save them, because they'll see Udyr if he comes through for a lane gank, because they're so pushed. They could see Udyr if he comes from jungle. And then if they do, they can easily react. Like, Ezreal has his blink, arcane shift. Lulu's W has increased movement speed. She can... No, it's ability power. Yeah, movement speed as well. Target 35% movement speed. So we'll see it right now. Udyr's coming for a gank. She's not there ward because of the Glitter Lance. Oh! Janna taking so much damage. He's going to first blood. No, not level 6 just yet. A lot of action happening in bot lane. Mid lane, it's just a farm fest. What about Jax on top? Let's see, 36 to 35 again. So, as I predicted, these two... The solo lane is just a farm fest. And here comes level 6, so this will be more interesting. Now it comes more harassment. Kali has level 6, she has all her charges. He goes, is she going to egg her? Yes, she gets egged at 7-17. So that's what Kali does well against Anivia. They both do well against each other, it just depends on skill. Kali should have the upper hand most of the time. Because she can always ulti onto Anivia, walk around her ultimate, and dodging her frost, her Q, Flash Frost. Back in the bot lane, some little harassment going on. Draven's not having his time of day, behind by 20 CS. At the moment, it seems like Rabid Gaming are winning in bot lane. 400 gold difference, not much. So it's not too much. It's probably because of the last hitting. We'll just take a look here. 2,000 to... Yeah, here you go. There's a 400 difference right there. Coming in gank from Udyr. Dodging everyone again. The polymorph into the arcane shift. So there you go. There is no threat worrying about an Udyr gank because she has got... Lulu has polymorph and the arcane shift for Ezreal. They can just kite Udyr all day long. Back in the top lane, some little harassment trading off. Xin Zhao is level 7 to... Jax level 6. In fact, Xin Zhao has taken advantage in last hitting the double Doran's blade. So he's got more damage, a bit more sustain, and a lot of health compared to Ninja Tabby from Baker. So it's, he's got a bit of damage mitigation, but compared to sustain, and also Zinzal's passive does reduce your armor. So in a way, at the moment, Zinzal is a stronger one. So if they're going to be trading off anymore, I still give it to Zinzal ahead. But we'll see how it goes, because Jax, you know, let him farm, he'll demolish late game. So going back to bot lane, back and forth trading. Draven is still behind by now 24 CS. So the longer this game goes, Draven's sort of early game dominance is going to worry thing. Like, early game is for Draven. The longer the game goes, I think entering mid game would be Ezreal's domain. And the thing is, Ezreal is winning early game, so he should have the advantage entering mid game as well. But I would like to see how this goes late game. How would it be late game? Because Ezreal does tend to scale down late game. Jax and Akali scale extremely well into late game. They'll instantly insta-kill anyone they see. Back in the top lane, we're having some trade-off. Oh, the Zinzal. Shen ultimate with an Udi gank. Oh, I can't believe I missed that. I have to react so much faster. Some of the spells burnt from Udyr and Jax as well. Yes, both burning flash to Zinzal's flash. So it was a good gank. It was a... He did not get burnt. He did not ulti. So it must have been a lane gank. Let's probably go back and see how that went. A few seconds. Ah, it's two back. A bit more back. Come on. Come on, chaps. So, they're harassing a bit. Obviously, Shen's coming through river. There is no wards. Comes in, baits in the kill, but also Udyr coming through the lane because of Jax being pushing the lane so well, he thought Udyr could have gone through without being noticed. And then obviously a little gank in between, burning ultimates, burning summoner spells. So not too much happened there. Coming to the next fight, we'll see how it goes with Shen's ult flash still up, so he can do some pretty gnarly flash taunts. We have yet to still see them use their teleport effectively and Shen ulti. One thing I like about Team Rabid, which I forgot to mention as well, is their global presence. They've got Shen's ult, they've got Zinzal ult. The thing is, they can split push all day long. They can, if Shen's ultimate's down, but Zinzal's TP is up, they can swap. So Zinzal will TP, will split push, where Shen will be in the middle of the fight. Vice versa. So they have a split push, constant pressure. Back in the mid lane, Shen's coming in for a gank. Can the Nivea land the Q? Nice wall, but wasn't really enough. Plants her ultimate and burns flash. Maybe that was just an instinct thing. Maybe it was just she got scared. Or it could be an accidental. But that burnt flash is going to prove pretty big, because now their only escape for a Nivea is if she can land a good wall and a flash frost, just like that, but like a much quicker reaction. So Akali should be pressing hard now, knowing Anivia's ult flash is down. But is her passive up? Yeah, her passive is up. Rebirth is back up. So Akali should, though, pressure it, but try to get that egg down and then go in for the kill afterwards. It should be 300 seconds till the flash up. Another 2 minutes and 13 seconds. Into a bot lane. Little gank. Nice Q from Janna into a nice E from Draven. Could this be first blood? Oh, the ultimate from Lulu. They're returning. Shen coming in with the ultimate. Oh, this is what I mean. They can jump all as much as they can onto anyone they choose. But all the damage, all the shields, all the, like, sort of peeling off just plays with them. Lulu ulting. Shen ulting. That's a huge shield. Another buff. So, yes, they can kill any squishy they want. But if they're both... But if somehow Lulu and Shen target ulti the same person, that person won't die anytime soon. So, it will, and then turns into the peeling off, get them off the out main damage. Oh! What did I miss? No! Trent, we're going to go back for that. Alright. Let's go back a bit. I was so busy talking about bot lane. So, I think there was some harassment coming from Akali onto Anivia. The minion giving the vision. Oh, amazing. Nice work. She used the minion to give vision, ulted onto Anivia, knowing Anivia had no flash frost, and just egged her and then took the kill. So again, so back when I was saying how they can peel for them, they can be beefy onto their squishies. Okay, granted, Shen can ulti, Lulu can ulti onto their squishies, but this is what I mean by Akali and Jax can instant kill anyone they choose. So, yes, they can protect, say, Ezreal, who's very squishy, but then who's protecting Anivia? So, they can kill Anivia. That's one damage dealer gone. Then they can, like, sort of kite out the rest, sort of peel off from the fire, and then re-engage onto Ezreal. And that's another. And then the thing is, though, this time there won't be any Shen ultimate. There won't be Lulu ultimate. They can instantly kill Ezreal. That leaves Shen, Xin Zhao, Lulu. Okay, Xin Zhao, beef Bruiser damage, but what else can you do? You won't have much damage coming from the rest, because the main damage dealers, who are very squishy, die. So we're going for like a Dragon Contempt. Oh, Janna, why? Probably came in with half health, three quarters health. Ezreal's ultimate. Yeah, that's so dumb comment. Oh, Cody, you noob. So getting caught by Ezreal's ultimate probably did a lot of damage. So incredible health, and that's a free dragon. It was probably going to either contest it, maybe clear the wards, get vision on it, but did not plan to give away the free blue free dragon. So who's got the kills now? I've got Ezreal. Main damage dealer getting kills. Akali getting first blood. She should use this to snowball against Anivia. Her passive is down. So she can... And I think this was about a minute ago they got the kill. So Akali has to capitalize on this. She has to go aggressive. She has to jump every moment. Try to get another kill off her. Or just shut down Anivia as much as possible. Otherwise Anivia will just be like, ulti, free farm. I ain't going nowhere, bitch. I'm counting stake. Stay even with you. Back in the top lane, Jax is a level behind. Is this going to be bad? He's got a Vampiric Sister for some sustain and a... Another fun time. He's gone for an early Hex deck, I think. Yeah, it must be an early Hex deck. Gunblade, which is pretty good. That's Jax's main item. But here we go, some trading off. Blocking Xin Zhao's Q, nice work. Baiting out Xin Zhao's Q with his dodge. And just a little back and forth trade. Seems like Xin Zhao is behind now. I think Jax can trade up evenly with him. But then again, it's a matter of skill. So he can go either way. I would like to see, because at the moment Xin Zhao's ahead of farm. Is he ahead of gold? Let's see, 3.9. Yeah, he's about 500. So getting the early health and Mercury's not bad. So he's gonna be more beefier. So he's running a bruiser thing for Xin Zhao. All right, planted. That's a pretty good idea. Who doesn't want more bruisers? But then, it just means targeting Ezreal and Anivia is more of a priority now. Because probably through Dust, they'll be like, okay, if we kill Ezreal and Anivia, again, no damage. Because Xin Zhao is building beef. Shen, beef. Yes, they'll be beefy enough we can't kill them, we won't insta-kill them. But then they won't be able to damage us back in return as much. Now coming through a gank, Udyr's coming down, Janna missing her Q. Is there a ward coming from? There was a ward here, that probably picked them, yeah. That ward, he picked them up. So yeah, now the pressure will be like, if we can kill Anivia and Ezreal, then we can, as a team, kill the rest off. Some little skirmishes back in mid lane and bot lane. Such great aggression coming from bot lane. I have to give it to this. This is Rabid Gaming. They've played exceptionally well on bot lane, putting the pressure on. Top lane, it's a bit of 50-50, so Xin Zhao proxy farming. Oh, the ping. Yep. Smart play. If this goes away, if they can get a kill, I want to see this. Here comes a gank from Udyr. He's on his own. Knocking back Udyr, but oh, can he fight? Yep, had to burn flash. So not bad. Burning flash of Xin Zhao. He's got no escapes afterwards. Good play, though. Don't know why she was trying to proxy farm. But here we go, another thing. Anivia. Oh, getting egged. There's a Shen ult. Oh, flash. Well done. Akali, I have to give it to you. You've baited out not only Anivia's egg, but you baited out Shen's ultimate. That is a good thing. So, Anivia's egg down. She egged her at 1630. Won't be up back to like about 2030. Shen's ultimate is down for another 192 seconds. They could do something here. So, right now, aggression jumping on from Jax onto Xin Zhao. Can't really trade off back in the bot lane. Draven taking them extremely low. Oh, the ultimate just missing. They have to pull back. That's going to be a free tower for Rabid Gaming again. There is no way Draven can contest that. Burning the ultimate to clear up the minion wave is still nothing. That's a free tower. Putting a lot of pressure in bot lane. I feel... So, Rabid Gaming bot lane is what's winning game. And here we go. That's caught out Lulu. Now she's dead. Or not. Oh, can she bait it out? She's flashed. Flash stun. Amazing by Udyr. Flash stun again. But that's a problem why Udyr is not a good ganker. He has to use flash to do stuff like that. Anyway, so coming down to bot lane, Jax did use teleport. Where did he teleport to? There must have been a ward. I can't remember, I can't see the ward. Anyway, Great work, but now this gives Inzao a free tower push, so that's going to be a free tower. Shen, pushing mid lane, he could get a free tower, that's extremely low. Yes, push bot lane, but you're risking two towers. So yeah, that top tower's gone, mid lane's gone, for bot lane. So pretty much what happened was, this is a trade-off. They lost two towers, actually three. They took the second inner tower. In retaliation, they lost, this is Rabid Gaming, they lost a kill on Lulu, but Udi had to burn his flash, and bot tower. So, I don't know if that was probably a good trade or not, I doubt it is. Down by 3k, I honestly don't reckon that was a good trade. But, who knows, maybe for Team Dusk, they felt like that trade was worth it, they felt like it was a good thing for them. So, back in top lane, they're probably doing a lane swap. Yeah, so Draven is behind. So much for early gaming frame, just 1 second. Yeah, so much family, so little time. So Draven's early game, it's gone. He has to try to get as much farm as much as possible, but again, deny Jack's farm, then your late game is also a bit weird too. So I don't know why they're sharing the farm. I would have thought ideal, say Draven probably went mid lane, because he probably could have traded with Anivia. Yeah, we could have traded with Anivia, but the problem is he didn't capitalize early game. They just could not win the early game against bot lane. Sorry about that, my food came. Alright, so you're going to hear me eat and talk at the same time. So bot lane, here we go, there's a dragon contestant, Zinzao zoning out. Three of the team, nice ultimate, Baker dropped down a half health, less than half, he's gonna die. That's oh, the flash, dodging the flash right, he's gonna get away with it. Oh no, oh no, Ezreal ultimate! Oh, perfectly, dodging it like a boss. Quick reaction time. Still, the chase is going on, no, they stopped chase, they're gonna clear up some of the jungle and pressure mid. So Jax has to pull back, Draven is gonna farm up a bit of the jungle, he's behind, so he needs to farm. And here comes the split push. Shen can split push bot lane. His ultimate is up. They'll be pressuring mid. Akali dropped down to near death experience. Still surviving. So at the moment, I'm giving my props to Rabid Gaming. They're going to win this game so much. Even though, you know, my team, Team Dusk, should be winning. They're putting up a valiant effort. Oh, yeah. Free coke. Oh, that's so nice. So 20 minutes in, it's been a low scoring game. Just want 3 kills. 3 deaths only happen. But a lot of farming. A lot of objectives have been taken. So like dragon, 2 dragons have gone to Rabid Gaming. They are 4-1 towers. So it's more of an objective game rather than a kill game. Which is good, which is what League of Legends should be more about. Only picking your fights on little things. But we'll see how that goes. There's Jax behind on farm. So even if it's a farming game, Team Dusk are behind in the farm, behind objective. So they lose. That's why they lose. That's why it's a 5k gold deficit. But again, the longer this game goes, say it goes into 40 minutes, 5k gold seems like nothing. And pretty much Team Dusk have this late game. Mid game is where Rabid Gaming shines. So I would like to see this game go in the late game. I still reckon it's anyone's game. It's just right now, Dusk are behind. So we can see what they can do. A lot of wards, a lot of vision. All in Dusk's jungle. This is, and there's like absolutely none in Rabbids because of towers. Like, dude, you take down mid tower, you have control of the jungle. This is why towers are so important. Because of towers, you get vision. Some little trade-offs there, little hits in there. Little hits back and forth. A lot of fights back and forth. I am so sorry. I have to keep beating my mic every time my family comes in. So little trades. Again, Team Dusk warding is crucial as a month. Knowing that Rabbit is going to be in the jungle. So they get a ward on their own jungle. And then just another entrance. So if they were going to pressure mid lane, there's a ward here. Case. it might come from their jungle. But Rabid's gaming, warding all the crucial points, just knowing exactly where they're going to be. They would know if they're in this jungle. If they're in this jungle, pretty much there's only two camps: Wraiths, Wolves, and Blue. This ward here, you can sort of see the skill shots coming from, so you'll be able to see it. Whereas in these wards, they reveal almost exactly when they are. Walk into the jungle, you'll know they're either here or here. Only other entrances have been warded, so you know if they're going to leave or not. So they're pushing down mid lane, and here comes a split push. Again, Shen has his ultimate, he can split push all day. Xin Zhao, top lane, has his teleport, split push all day. They had to send Draven to deal with Shen. Honestly, I don't think that's a good idea. I would have sent Jax myself because he has TP, but now he has to go top to deal with Xin Zhao, and he's going in there half health. That is not a good trade. Here goes, they're trading in. This is not going to be good for Jax. He had to burn ultimate, and Xin Zhao's taking a lot of tower aggro, but he's fine. Like, again, so nothing trade. He's going to take down that tower pretty well. It's a 3v3 mid lane, and a Draven versus Shen. Maybe Draven can use time to farm up. It could be good if they can just keep him off, but here you go, Shen jumping onto Draven. Shen is just so damn tanky. Draven is so behind. That early game, oh, that set Draven up behind so much. I guess the problem with this thing is they should have a good early game because of Draven, good late game with Akali and Jax. But Draven's bad in late game, he could not do anything. Back into Shen getting caught out, he's gone with ulti! The stun from Udi is stopping him, amazing! But they also lost middle tier 2 tower, so I don't know if that's a good thing. But they just stopped Shen. Shen's ultimate is going to be down, so that's one split push they can handle. Now TP from Xin Zhao, so they can send Jax against Xin Zhao for the split push to deal with him. Shen can't split push because his ultimate is down now. I reckon Dusk should pressure mid now hard, go back, reheal, and start pressuring mid hard. Let Jax go against Xin Zhao for the split push because they both have TP. But Shen can't split push. Once Shen's on another lane, push down that lane as hard as they can, because it'll be 3v4. And I doubt Rabid Gaming, despite being all so early, can handle 3v4 just yet. But at the moment, 6k gold? No, 5k gold. Still a 5k gold advantage. So if they can consistently keep the 5k gold until into late game, it's going to mean nothing. So all's well. Rabid Gaming, they're playing amazing. But Dusk are doing a not too bad effort as well. They're heading kills. Alright, sweet. They're doing pretty well in kills. They keep, not so bad based on vision. But they're doing as hard as they can. They're trying to keep up. Akali is going to get caught out. Xin Zhao charging in. But here comes the cavalry to save the day. Yeah, I'm going to like this game. I'm really itching to see it going to late game. I really want to eat. Right. Now, Dusk, there's nothing much Dusk can do. I reckon just wait it out, try to farm as much as you can, get to late game, because late game is when they will probably shine more. Because late game, you've got Akali and Jax who can instant-mount anyone. You then got Udu who becomes pretty much unkillable. Granted, Shen is in Zhao building beefy, but like, Udu will be unkillable and he'll somehow magically do a lot of that. Oh, they're pressuring the Baron. Yep, they know it'll be a 3v5. No, 2v5, and they're pushing bot lane. They're sending Draven out to deal with it. That's a 4v2. And here you go, 4v2, flash onto Xin Zhao. They've got 4v2 against it. They've got no damage because it's just Lulu and it's just Xin Zhao. But Janna dies. Xin Zhao is just so damn beefy with the Lulu ultimate, and then that's a kill. Akali going aggressive. She can probably get this. No, she can't. But they're going to lose bot tower for it. Yeah, so that trade was so not worth it. They lost. They got a kill, lost the kill, but they're losing bot tower and probably bot inhibitor. Definitely not worth it. Draven shouldn't have been trying to deal with them, in my opinion. I reckon should have Draven and Janna. But here we go, come back on the chase. Nice flash for us, stopping Udyr. There's going to be no stun in time. Oh, the flash from Jax into a leaf strike. Gets a stun. Shen accidentally trying to taunt him, but he gets stunned from Udyr. Again, Jax still chasing on. They're going to go for Jax. Sean taunting over to where Draven is. Can Draven capitalize on this? Oh, gets juked. I gets juked again. Oh my gosh. Silver Trey stunning. Oh, and if Anivia is not going to last. And here comes in Zhao with his teleport. Anivia has been egged. And Akali coming for the cavalry. Who is she going? Shen ult. Oh, she's going straight for Ezra. Oh, she should have just gone for Akali. Oh, this has gone so south bad. So bad. What is happening? Oh, the war from Anivia. They're chasing down Akali. Akali's gone. Shit. Diane. John all by herself pops a shield. She's going to get caught. Pops Shirelius. And there she goes. Oh my god. What is happening? Again, it's probably... It's just... Oh, so kited so well. The peeling from Rabid Gaming. That's how it is. It was the peels. That and also, you can kite Udyr. And they have no real engagement. Jax had to engage, but he has to be the hyper carry that kills everyone. So you can't. How can you engage with the hyper carry? It won't go. It won't go successful. So 4-4-1 was a trade. No, they didn't lose anyone. So it's 4-4-none. And now they're just tanking down mid tower. Gonna get the mid tower and probably back up. Great play from Rabid Gaming. So that's from a 5k advantage to a 10,000k advantage. Double the advantage. It's pretty good. So I guess it was just a miscommunication from Dusk team. But now this just sets them back a bit more. Like they had a chance. Again, they have to get to late game. It's going to be a bit harder now getting to that late game. Now I love my food. So now with bot lane pushing, what Rabid Gaming going to do, and this is what I reckon should do, they would pressure top lane. Pressure top lane. Once one of Team Dusk has to go down and deal with bot lane, that's a free Baron. Because they'll be in bot lane, the only one who can actually do it would be Jax, because he's got teleport. So I guess the communication would be, send Jax to deal with bot lane, if they contest Baron, which they're doing right now, so here you go. Dusk already on it, and Jax will TP into a fight. This Baron fight, I think, if Team Dusk lose it, they lose the game. Honestly, clearing up some wards, nice vision ward in the Baron pit. So yeah, if Dusk loses this fight, I think this Baron fight, they will lose the game. If they win, they can still come back. It won't be that over just yet. So, sending Draven's had to go deal with top lane. That's going to be a free uncontested Baron. They have no vision whatsoever. Clearing another ward from Team Dust. There is no vision anymore. And that's going to be an uncontested Baron. That's a free Baron. No vision whatsoever. Jax is still busy with doing bot. And now here comes Rabid Gaming for the chase. Jumping on Janna. Janna getting caught out. Can she get away? The exhaust onto Xin Zhao. And the E from Draven. Oh! He put him into Xin Zhao's E. Xin Zhao's range. Oh! Draven, why? You killed your Janna. That stand aside, that you put Xin Zhao into a good audacious charge range. Team fight happening under Baron, but it's under tower, but it's going south so bad. Again, the peelers coming from Rabid Gaming, just protecting their ADC, protecting their Anivia. You can't get past their front line. Their front line is too big. It was a 4-for-none exchange. Udi had to run out. They can't do it. That's going to be a free top inhibitor, free middle inhibitor. That's all three inhibitors down. I reckon they're just going to push to win the game. 20 seconds up to like a main damage dealer comes. Janna is up. They can try their hardest to keep this game up, but I highly doubt it. Yep, there's GG. Game's called. Good game, Rabid Gaming. This is me first time showering. I think I did good. Oh, I instant killed Udyr. Well, wish me luck. Good game, Rabid. You did really well. See you guys. This is King Tripty signing out.